when you figure out how you're lost in the moment, you disappear. You don't have to be afraid to put your dream in action. You're never gonna fade, you'll be the main attraction. Life fantasy, just remember me when it turns out right. Cause you know that if you live in your imagination, tomorrow you'll be everybody's fascination. In my victory, just remember me when I make it shine.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Verdugo Rundown.
I'm your host Mel.
And I'm your host Ethan.
And although we are approaching the end of the school year, we still have some fun segments for you guys.
So let's get started. Hey guys, I'm Sam.
And I'm Melissa.
Today we're going to be reviewing Met Gala outfits.
We have Lala, who's going to show us pictures. So the first person that we're going to be doing is Sebastian Stan. And I thought that he was wearing a fully magenta outfit. And I thought that that was really original because everyone else was just wearing basic black or maybe navy. So I think that was like really standout.
It's a very loud outfit. It's also very ugly. I don't really like it.
It's ugly?
Yeah. I would never wear that.
Okay, so the next person is Kylie Jenner.
The hat that she's wearing is kind of like, no, with the whole like bridal theme and then just adding a random like baseball cap to it. But I mean, the dress is cool, I guess, but I don't really know about the hat.
I just feel like it didn't match the theme. Like, it was so out of the blue, and like why was there a hat? Like, what was the point of the and why was it backwards?
Yeah, that's like,
couldn't it be like a different hat that was normal? Like, I don't know.
Or even like
why was there like a veil too? Like,
yeah.
She looked like she was late to her own wedding, stopped at the Met Gala and was like, oh wait, let me show up to my wedding. Like, what? Oh, I wouldn't wear it. Would you?
No, I wouldn't wear that one.
You wouldn't wear that one either. So our next person is Shawn Mendes.
That's like probably the most normal looking outfit I've seen so far. It also like goes with the theme.
It does go with the theme. It's like, it's giving very much like Anthony Bridgerton, like from Bridgerton. Like, I feel like it matches the theme. It just looks like good. And
it
like,
looks like medieval-y and like Europe-y or whatever.
I like, yeah. Like the collar, like this part is like really good. It just looks. Okay, so our next person is Olivia Rodrigo.
Okay, so far, best outfit. I love Olivia Rodrigo. Olivia is like,
so we're biased, but we think she looks great.
Yeah. The only thing, it doesn't go with the theme at all, and it kind of looks like a prom dress. And I don't really know why she would wear that, but
yeah, it was kind of like, it doesn't really match the theme, but because
but since
we
she's
love
Olivia
her,
Rodrigo,
we love it.
Yeah, exactly.
12 out of 10, we love it.
Right. I'd wear it.
Yeah, I would too. And I went to an Olivia Rodrigo concert. Here's a picture.
Sam. I didn't go to the concert, but
yeah, he wasn't
invited. I love Olivia Rodrigo.
Okay. We don't know who this person is, but here's the picture.
He looks like a penguin, like the whole like.
Dude, he looks like an undercover. Like, he looks like there should be a person like under him, and he's like being carried or something.
I feel like he like genuinely has to like waddle.
Yeah, like he has to like walk. Like, who looked at that and was like, oh yeah, I love this. Let me wear this to the Met Gala. Like, who did that? And whoever dressed him like is fake. Also, what is his like? What is going on with
like a
barn
or, I don't
what
know.
What is, I don't really know. I can't really see.
And he has like, actually never mind. He has like a princess like shoulder
it's
pad.
Like, yeah, puffy. Shoulder pad like buffs. Like, it's just ugly. Would you wear it? No.
I'd wear it.
You'd wear it?
Yeah, it's hard. I'd wear it.
Okay, the next person is Blake Lively, and she always looks the best. Every Met Gala, she does no wrong.
I still think Olivia Rodrigo like does it better, but you know, it's cool. Probably like, yeah, actually, yeah, second best outfit. I like the whole like transforming into
when it switched.
Yeah, because like themed after the Statue of Liberty.
Yeah, it was like after the Statue of Liberty, and then they just like she was on the stairs and they were just like, and like there it was. It was so good.
Yeah.
Would you wear it? I would definitely wear it. Actually, I feel like I couldn't wear it as well as she did, so I wouldn't.
I wouldn't wear it. And yeah.
So the next person is Kim Kardashian. What did you think?
It's like the Marilyn Monroe dress. Yeah, I was gonna say Manson, but it's like her dress, right?
Yeah, yeah, it was her dress that they, was it from Florida, I think? And they took the dress out. Where was it from? It was like from a museum, and they had it like taken out. And then she switched into a replica of it, so she wasn't wearing it while she was sitting and
stuff. Yeah, like the real one didn't fit her or something. It was like,
it like barely fit. She just wore it on the carpet. But I mean, like, everyone's like kind of mad about it or like something. I don't really have an opinion on it. I think it was like, shouldn't have been as controversial as it actually was.
I mean, it's like gilded glamour, right? That's the, yeah. I mean,
it didn't fit the theme.
I don't think, yeah, that doesn't really fit the theme. No. Marilyn Monroe's like a Hollywood person. That's kind of like glamour, I guess.
But no, she was definitely glamorous, but she wasn't from the gilded age. Like,
yeah,
that was like a million years ago. I guess.
Yeah.
Okay. And the real question, who wore it better?
Who wore it better? I think Marilyn, because it was her dress.
Yeah, it's her dress.
Yeah.
I haven't seen the photo or anything, but I'm just, yeah.
And that's it for our monthly review.
We're never doing one of these again.
It's the last one.
We're seniors. School ends in like 2 weeks. Or by the time you're watching this, probably like the last week of school or something. It's over. And yeah, bye.
Bye.
Wait, how do you do the, wait, okay, there.
Bye. Bye.
Alright, so unfortunately your hosts aren't here, so you got me instead, but we still have, yay!
Hi, welcome back to Chicken Sandwich Wars. My name is Richard De La Rosa and I'll be your substitute host for today with our out of commission hosts, Jamie Vasquez and Alan Hernandez. So today, we'll be reviewing Harry's Hot Chicken with our special guest, Nayeli Murrow.
The chicken sandwich was all right. I didn't like the chicken. I didn't like the way it was cooked. I also didn't like the way that the coleslaw tasted in it. So just overall, it was okay and it could have been a little better. So I'd give it a 6 out of 10.
The sandwich is really, really plain. I really don't like it. The chicken is kind of overcooked, and the bread with the chicken and everything, it doesn't really have a taste, in my opinion, but the sauce is the only part that really brings it all together, so I give it a 5 out of 10.
I think the sandwich was good. The bread was soft. I think the pickles and the slaw really tied it together. The chicken itself, it was well seasoned, but I think the spice level really made all that difference compared to the mild that Alan had. Since he said it was plain, I think that the spice level made it a little bit better. So overall, I give it a 6.5 out of 10.
So overall, we all agreed that the sandwich just was dry, didn't have enough spice, and not to mention the fact that the buns weren't good enough. We give it an overall score of 6 out of 10.
Hi, I'm Alan.
Hi, I'm Jamie.
And welcome back to Chicken Sandwich Wars.
This time we'll be doing Hell's Chicken.
With our special guest, Coach Lee.
Hi, I'm Mr. Lee. I'm ready to chow down. I'm a teacher here. I'm ready to eat.
And now let's eat.
It was a little dry, but you can tell that it's actually real chicken as opposed to some of the others. I didn't like the fact that it used a chicken finger and a type of bun. It almost like a hot dog bun. It didn't, you know, fill up. The ratio wasn't good. Like the bun was falling apart. And the bun itself, I like my bun a little crispy on outside, soft, so kind of toasted. It wasn't that way, but I get the kind of thing they're trying to do. And then the coleslaw. The coleslaw lacked acidity. And that, you know, acidity brings the flavor out in the food. And overall, I didn't think the spice level on the sandwich, like it was coated well, but the spice wasn't there. Maybe because it was mild. I mean, that could be preference. But, you know, probably a 6 here. Still a quality sandwich, but it's lacking a little bit.
A 10.
We all liked the sandwich overall. We really liked the sauce. It was just the bread that was the issue for all of us. We probably would have liked it cooked a little differently, but we did like the sandwich. Hi, I'm Jamie.
And I'm Alan.
And welcome back to Chicken Sandwich Wars.
And this time we'll be taste testing Cluckin' Chicken.
And with our special guest, Zavi Chikinis.
Hello, my name is Zavi Chikinis, and I am a track and field captain.
And now for the taste test.
Wow, Zavi, this is really good. Where'd you get this?
Hey man, don't worry about it. But it's the best drink out there right now, Prime Hydration.
Thanks.
Alright, for the sandwich, the pros are the chicken is pretty good. The bun adds like a...
Certified.
We're starting?
Overall, it was an 8.5 out of 10.
The only thing that was really lacking for most of it was just the sauce.
It's time for the moment you've been waiting for.
Action.
But last year felt just as high as every year. Please tell me more. What else do you know?
Hold on. Wait, that's kind of
what's going on. But which one are we both excited to see?
Probably Harry Styles.
Harry Styles.
Probably Harry Styles.
Probably.
Yeah. His concert was crazy. Do you remember the time where they were making like a conga pit?
A conga pit? A conga line, you mean? In the pit area? Yeah.
Did we get some info from our crew?
Yeah.
Okay.
Melon's here.
Hello, I'm Mel.
Hi, I'm Sam.
I don't know what to say.
I stalled for you guys.
It's fine. Am I too tall? Because I'm not crouching right now.
You're fine.
Oh, okay. Happy.
Can we have Lala or one of you count down the 1-2?
Our fourth teammate isn't here, Jaden. I don't know where he is. Anyways, these are the tables.
Everybody, 1, 2, 3.
And that's it for this month's rundown.
Until next time, bye.
I didn't say anything.
It's okay, they won't know.
Yeah, you should probably wash it.
The lady was literally like putting it in the trash.
I'm eating it, but you know, join our minion club.
What advice
do you have for me?
Good choice.
Okay.
That's not advice.
Super Bowl 56.
Go, what is it?
Vaquero.
Make sure that you fill out your financial aid early.
We love free money.
The best protein.
Make sure to do your financial aid. FAFSA.
My advice to underclassmen is that don't worry. I know that college...
ARPA, what's your guide to...
Go Verdugo! 2023 MVP LeBron!
Hey!
Okay, are we talking at the same time?
Hey guys!
Yeah, okay.
And that's it for this month's rundown.
Hope you all have a great rest of your school year. Bye!